Ah, it's summertime. Fishing is easy, right? Well, not always. In most parts of the country, we are in full-blown summer fishing, or farther up north, maybe a little bit of spawn going on and still into post-spawn, but it's not gonna be long, and those better fish are all of a sudden not in the shallows or not as willing to bite. And oftentimes, to be successful in the summer, it means distance. And what I mean by that is getting our lure far away from the boat or where we're standing on the shoreline. We want to get that distance as far as we can possibly get. The bass, the better bass, are very aware of our presence by this time of year. So let's go ahead and start off with horizontal distance. Translates directly to long cast. If you're finesse fishing, Ned rig, shaky heads, these types of things, that means using spinning gear. And then I like to put braid with a fluorocarbon leader on my spinning gear. I can cast so much farther than if I was using straight monofilament. And it has to do with line twist. Braid is very, very easy to use, and it doesn't like to get all telephone cord like monofilament will very quickly. Like I said, translates directly to casts that go much, much, much farther. Now, if you're using things like some topwaters, big topwaters, deep diving, crankbaits, swim jigs, other horizontal types of lures that are traditional bait cast lures, you want to make sure that you get the weight of the lure and the bait caster set up correctly. I'll link a video down below that talks about that specifically. But once you have got those adjustments made, now you're going to want to back off, especially that magnetic brake, usually accessed on the outside of the side plate, and maybe the spool tension a bit, and just heave that thing, but keep that thumb close to the spool. We need to practice and need to get much, much farther cast. That is directly going to translate to more bites. This is better fish. Not huge, but that'll work. And that is what happens when you get some distance. Now, with those long horizontal casts, I like to use straight fluorocarbon or braid with a leader to eliminate that line stretch. If I've got a big walking topwater out there and I have a ton of line out there, I don't want that extra stretch that monofilament often has. I want to translate that energy right to that hook set. The other one is getting distance vertically. Okay, that means fishing deeper. I like to use a drop shot rig when I am doing this, but we've really got to consciously make a decision. How deep do I normally fish on my home lake or home body of water? So this one here, I'm usually in that 15 to 20 foot range a lot of times. So I need to consciously tell myself, you know what? Let's focus on that 20 foot plus. Make yourself fish deeper, focus on those electronics, or if you're a shore angler, fish in areas where you can get deeper, easier. So many bodies of water, especially in the northern parts of the country, but I fished plenty of these down south as well. I can see the bottom in 15, 20 foot. I mean, I think of Bull Shoals Lake, for example. So I've got to get my lures past that. Get it where they are not aware of our presence as easily. Now, with the drop shot rig, I like to go heavier weights, power shot, get that lure down to depth much, much quicker. So I'm not, you know, sitting there in the boat just waiting and waiting and waiting for the lure to get there. Other ways to extend that vertical depth is if you like to use, you know, swim baits, or if you like to use a jig, a big football jig, for example. Really make that long cast, let them sink all the way to the bottom, even a swim bait, let it sink all the way to the bottom, and then go ahead and give it a slight little twitch, and then just reel it slow enough where you maintain that bottom contact. You're just ticking the bottom. Oftentimes with lures like a swim bait, we will just kind of keep a steady retrieve to it, and it keeps pulling farther and farther up and off the bottom. Stop your retrieve if you have to and let it get back down there again. Give it a little bit of slack, let it hit that bottom again, and then continue the retrieve. Maintain that vertical distance that we want in the summertime.
And if you'd like to watch a video that talks about, well, how do I pick out that great starting depth? Because waters are very different. They vary greatly. Go ahead and check this one out right here. And make sure to go out and encourage someone today. You never know how you might just change their life. For the Bass Fishing Life, I'm your host, Steve Rogers.